Hello, my lichens. Welcome to another issue of Ants Morning, my newsletter podcast. This is the December edition, almost too late, but not quite. And it's titled Grinding Teeth into Palm Trees, because I couldn't help myself doing yet another weird title. Okay, let's go. 1. All this chatter. Let me kick this off with a poem. This is one of the pieces from the last book I read, which is a whole victory in itself because my attention span is very low right now. And it's written by one of my friends from Neil Hirborn's writing circle. I told you more about this in a past issue, titled Escribir de Madrugada, and I think in English it was Writing at Dawn, if I'm not mistaken. Some of the poems sound familiar to me from the circle, and it's pretty beautiful seeing how they evolved and ended up in a collection alongside other pieces I didn't know but still make perfect sense together, and recognizing my friend's voice in them all. Yep, it's a pretty amazing feeling. The collection is titled Grinding Teeth into Flowers, and the cover art was made by B. Criswell, an artist you can find on Instagram. Their handle is shophoneybeenies, and they describe themselves there as queer, fat, Midwestern, non-binary. And I love it. I absolutely love it. The cover has a black background with the text on white on top. And there's a drawing depicting a human yo. A human yo? Is that how you pronounce it? I don't know. It has purple, red, and white flowers and green leaves on top of it. Okay, let me read you the poem now. Content warning for mental health stuff. The title is All This Music by Briar T. Quinn. The room is littered with music boxes. Beautiful little boxes that you picked out just for me. I want to break them with my teeth. Because when I told you, I hear music, it's like music boxes. I didn't mean, I love music boxes. What I meant was, I have auditory hallucinations. The books on the shelf sing. My paintings on the wall, they all talk, mindless chatter I can't shut out. The oasis of the bed we share whispers in the night that I'm not good enough for you. So yeah, sometimes I think of burning the bed and getting a new one that doesn't talk, leaving the tongue of the old one in ashes. And maybe I want to rip my paintings into cat litter or some shit some nights. But it's mostly the music boxes that haunt me. So let me eat the music. And don't make me tell you why. Yes. Yes. Amazing. And if you're curious, you can check out the Spanish translation I did on the Spanish version of this podcast or the newsletter. And I highly recommend you reading the whole collection. You can find Briar on Twitter at Briar T. Quinn. On Facebook at Briar T. Quinn, and on Instagram as Briar Quinn Poetry. And their collection, Grinding Teeth into Flowers, I'm in love with the title, by the way, it's available on Amazon and Smashwords, both in physical and in digital format. I'm taking this chance to congratulate Briar on publishing such a heartbreaking yet tender first poem collection. full of personal experiences, but not falling on self-pitying, putting trauma over the table but aiming at healing, sometimes through rage, and that's totally valid and I'm here for it. When I say grinding teeth into flowers, I also think if you can grind teeth into flowers, of course ancient seeds can grow into trees, right? My brain does weird connections, so that's what I connected it to. What can I do? Okay, second point. Methuselah, ancient big boy. There's an article on Treehugger titled "Extinct Tree Grows Anew from Ancient Jar of Seeds Unearthed by Archaeologists," and it was written by Stephen Messenger. This one was published in 2019, and it basically says that since the 500th AC, the Judean palm tree has been extinct, but an archaeological team in the 60s found in Israel's Herod the Great's palace, a ceramic recipient with 2,000-year-old seeds. In 2005, botanical researcher Elaine Soloway thought, well, why not planting them? And the seeds she planted didn't only take root and turned into a tree. In 2011, it bloomed for the first time. This palm tree was named, of course, Methuselah. And in 2018, his planter said about the tree in another Treehugger article, this one titled "Date Palm Grown from 2,000-Year-Old Seed is a Dad," and it was written by Melissa Breyer. In that article, Elaine Soloway is quoted, and she said, "He is a big boy now. He is over 3 meters, or 10 feet, tall. He's got a few offshoots. He has flowers, and his pollen is good. We pollinated a female with his pollen, a wild female, and yeah, he can make dates." Amazing, right? 3. The stars' blood. I feel brighter when they write about grinding teeth because I grind mine every night. Although I wear those thingies you put in your mouth so you don't grind as much. But yeah, I still do it a bit. And I was writing about this thing a few months ago, and I wanted to share a tiny fragment with a translation, and I'm pretty proud of myself for coming up with this shit. So yeah, let me read you the ending of this poem. "So hush, let the night come. Open up your mouth. Enter the world through your cavities and clack with it all. Calcify the stars' blood. Open up." Bruxism as cosmic experience? Why not? Am I right? 4. A cucumber signing with their own merit. Why do I come up with this weird titles? I don't know, I like them. Sorry, not sorry. I've also recently discovered Craig P. Barrow's photographic work. You can find him on cpbarrows.com, and Barrows with B-U-R-R-O-W-S. And he was inspired by Alexander Olovachov's work, who also did UVIVF photography. And that is ultraviolet-induced visible fluorescence. Barrows explains it a bit in his frequently asked questions section, and let me read a bit. is a process in which given wavelengths of ultraviolet radiation are absorbed by a material's molecules, causing them to achieve an excited state. Through this, fluorescent materials lose small amounts of energy through other mechanisms until they can drop to a suitable ground state by releasing a photon of a specific energy and wavelength. Since energy was lost before the remainder was released as a photon, the wavelength of that photon is longer than the stimulating source, which means an ultraviolet light is able to produce dramatic visible fluorescence. All the light in the photograph is originating from within the subject itself. I won't lie, I don't fully understand it, but the pictures look amazing. So I decided to take one as a drawing reference. By the way, this is the author's Instagram and he updates it quite a lot, so go follow him. He's at CP Burrows Photo. Okay, the original picture I chose is a picture of a... It's a photograph of a cucumber flower, which we usually see as white with green stacks, but with the UV-IVF technique, it looks blue, with blue petals, I mean, and the centers of the petals are... pink, the stalk is reddish fuchsia almost, and the center, the stamens, are a very, very bright yellow. There's also bits of pollen over the petals, and they look like tiny bright dots. It's pretty awesome. I recommend you look it up on this newsletter version, on the written version, I mean. And I decided to kind of copy it, but not really. It's not really super realistic. I used it more as an inspiration. And I drew it with color pencils on paper. And the only big difference, apart of it not being exactly the same, is the background. The original picture is in black, and I don't usually use the black pencils or black colors in general when I paint or when I draw. So I just ignore the black pencil. And I just put layers upon layers of red, blue, purple, and deep green. And that way I think the background looks richer in texture. And if you zoom in, you kind of see the bluish, greenish, and even the reddish parts. And I love that. So yeah, that's what I did. This month I already shared another thing with my Likens over Patreon for my work in progress perk, but next month I'll share the process of this drawing that, by the way, took more or less 6 hours, not in one sitting of course, and I enjoyed every minute of it, if I'm honest. Well, you know how it goes. You can go to patreon.com/MiriamNavarroPrieto, and for just €1 or $1.50 a month, you can get monthly updates on what I'm doing, which is basically drawings and poems. And that way you'll also help me continue writing this very newsletter podcast and doing my overall creative stuff, and I will be very, very grateful. 5. An Arthurian Farewell. I'll close this off with another fragment from Grinding Teeth into Flowers by Briar T. Quinn, and this one feels like a hug. You never remember the color of your eyes, so I tell you, blue is green, because sunlit moss in a clear lake in a dream I once had about King Arthur coming back to life doesn't seem helpful, but damned if it isn't true. So yeah, go right now, buy the book. It's beautiful and heartbreaking. Yes, I recommend it. And that's all for now. Thank you, my patrons, Rufi and Jorge, my fans from the beginning. Larry, a constant inspiration. Go look her up at patreon.com/LHWritesPoetry. And also Lucia, the high school counselor I'd have loved to have, but didn't, sadly. And let me add my non-official Patreon, someone whose help is key for me to do what I love. Nacho, I'm your fan, you're great. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, if you haven't subscribed yet to this newsletter podcast, you can do so on tinyletter.com/MiriamNavarroPrieto. Don't forget to wait for the email TinyLetter will send you and click on the confirmation link inside. Oh, and I think you can also subscribe on Spotify to the podcast version. Well, it's not a subscription. I think you can just click on a notifications button and they send you a notification when I upload a new episode. So, yeah. Oh, you can also listen to me talking every month on Anchor and on YouTube. Yeah, that's all for this month. Until January, yes. I hope you have some nice, cozy holidays, and I hope they weren't bad, at least, because I know they can be bad. So yeah, take care of yourself and all that, and yeah, bye!